morning, fanatics, crazy Russian dead here, driving to work is normal. Reflecting upon how complex our life has become. Our lives have become. We used to have a lot of time. I mean, that's how I feel. We had a lot of time and now we don't have any time. I'm not talking some time-space Einstein continuum. When I first came to this country, this is now many years ago, I actually used to write letters. Okay, like an actual letter, you know, by hand. I would get my pen out and I would get a sheet of, sorry, cannot pronounce it, but you know, of paper. And I would write, Dear Kirill. Kirill was my best friend from high school. And I would tell him, listen, I'm in America now and this happened and that happened. I would ponder and reflect and write a couple of pages and then lovingly fold it and put in the envelope. That's how my father-in-law says it. I know it's probably envelope. And then send it. And then 2 weeks later, it would make it, you know, to Russia. And then 8 weeks later, I would receive a letter. It was wonderful. Now I can just text him or something and say, what's up, Kirill? And he'll be like, oh, I don't know, I'm too busy. I don't know, making money or whatever they do there right now. So completely different. As a child growing up and, you know, in the old country, phones were different than phones now, right? I mean, in many ways, four ways or three ways. I don't. First, it was pretty special that we had a phone, okay, in the apartment where we lived. But if not everybody had phones, I'm sure maybe, I don't know, 200 years ago here in America, it was the same. I mean, phone was attached to apartment, not to a person. So you were either lucky because you had a phone in your apartment, or you didn't. We had, my family, I guess, was lucky and had phone. But it was different than, it was a rotary phone. You know, one of those. You probably don't even know, you think this is special effects. No, no, no. Look it up on, go on Google and type in rotary phone. You will see, I mean, you will be amazed how your iPhone used to look like only 25 years ago in Russia. Second is you could get a busy signal, you know, like if somebody was on the phone, you would get a busy signal. It's called busy signal. Okay, again, youngsters, you don't know what it means, but busy signal means somebody is on the phone talking to somebody other than you. Remarkable. And then the third most remarkable thing was that somebody could just not be home. You see, like if somebody is not home, the phone would ring and ring and nobody would pick it up. By the way, and all of it was somehow okay. Like you would call your friend and like, all right, he's not home. That's cool. I mean, I'll call him back. Like I wouldn't like start texting him and messaging him and Skyping him and Facebooking him and Instagramming him and I don't know. Like these days it seems, I think the only reason you would not get a hold of somebody to talk to them, there's only one reason, basically. It's if they don't want to talk to you, right? Because you have options, right? You can Skype, you can text, you can Viber, you can WhatsApp, you can, I don't know, direct message on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I mean, let's not forget Snapchat and Pinterest and I don't know what else. And that's just for the old people like me. I'm sure, like, teenagers already know about some other hot things like, I don't know, Peach and whatever, You Now. And anyway, this is not a course on social media, and I'm certainly severely not qualified. But times are just so complicated now. Like, in my favorite movie, you know, have you seen Ben-Hur? It's a great movie. It's a great movie, all 4 hours of it. But, yeah. Well, I need to give you a little bit of context, but just so you understand what I'm about to say. So there is this Judah Ben-Hur. He's a prince of Judea. He gets framed or something. Anyway, he prince, Jewish prince, but becomes slave, not slave, becomes framed for a crime, goes to the galleys, chained to the oar, spends years in the galleys, but he's tough. Charlton Heston is tough, but so he survives. Anyway, so now pay attention. He saves a Roman general. This is in the time of Christ and the Roman Empire, right? Way back, before Soviet Russia. So he saves this Roman general, and then with it they save the whole Roman fleet and win some kind of important battle against, I don't know who, some barbarians of some kind. I hate this seatbelt. So anyhow, and for that, he is given his freedom and he comes to Rome with this general or tribune or something, legionnaire, I don't know. And then they come and they visit who? Guess, they visit Caesar himself, who was like, it's like Barack Obama of the day, okay? But probably even more powerful, because Roman Empire, they own like half the freaking planet. Anyhow, so they come and they visit Caesar. Beautiful scene, they walk up about 1900 steps, but that's okay, movies were slower back then. Anyhow, but what does the Caesar say to this, to our hero, to Charlton Heston? To the Tribune. Charlton Heston doesn't say much. I guess slaves or former criminals are not allowed to speak in the presence of the emperor. But he basically says to the Roman general, come tomorrow, we'll talk of him. I mean, that's all he says. I mean, basically, he wants to be generous and he wants to give this guy freedom. It's a big deal in ancient Rome. But he says, come tomorrow, we'll talk of him. I mean, that phrase always blew me away because he doesn't say, come tomorrow at 6 p.m. I don't know, like, make an appointment with me on Outlook and come. Well, he just says, come tomorrow. Now, I don't know, maybe in ancient Rome, come tomorrow means come tomorrow sunset. Or maybe somehow you see Caesar when Caesar can see you. But I mean, just think how different life is now. Like, I cannot say just come tomorrow to my friends. Life used to be so simple. Like, my wife and I, way back, seemingly before children, not that many years ago, we would like just kind of like hang out, I think that's the term, with friends. You know, you would call them on your phone and you'd say, you guys want to like do something? And friends would say, yeah, you know, of course, because that's what friends do. Well, now, before the weekend, if I call, if I call them, they will say, well, we're booked for the next 4 weekends. Our little Josh Elich has a recital at the Carnegie Hall and a Symphony Hall and a, Jordan Hall. There are many halls in America. So, I mean, it's unbelievable. Like, you need to schedule fun. I mean, how fun is that when you need to schedule fun? I mean, this is ridiculous. It's like, I need to schedule when I go play tennis with my children. I mean, I don't do that. We just go and play. But even my children, like on Saturday, I need to take my younger boy to conservatory. He's actually quite talented. And I'm talented at driving him. And by the way, across from the conservatory, there's a nice place where I buy a bagel. It's called Everything Bagel. Everything. They put everything on it. I love it. Anyhow, but I digress. So life used to be simpler and now it's more complex. And speaking of complex, this video is almost 9 minutes. I am trying to keep it under 5 and some of my fanatics tell me, listen, it should really be under 2 minutes. That's all people have attention spent for these days. But anyhow, I don't know if we're any happier for it. I think we're just busier and more neurotic. Speaking of neurotic, where is Woody Allen? I mean, I hope he's alive and well. But he used to make nice movies about like this neurotic Jewish guy himself, and I haven't seen, I mean, I saw something of him, but it was a murder mystery. It was completely disturbing and meshuggah. But I think he could make a movie about this. Somebody, any of you guys, if any of you are movie making type, somebody should make a movie about how times have just become crazy, too busy, people are too neurotic, multitasking and all that. Anyhow, I hope you can watch this video. It's now almost 10 minutes. I mean, if I continue talking, it will be even more, but I will not. Listen, times are tough. Simplify your life. I'm gonna try to just relax this coming weekend, okay? Good night.